dramatic move today by an anchor for the network Russia Today America. Her name is Liz Wall. She's an American who works in the Russia Today America's Washington bureau. She accused her employer of glossing over the actions of Vladimir Putin in Crimea, and then on the air, she quit. Take a look.
I cannot be part of a network funded by the Russian government that whitewashes the actions of Putin. I'm proud to be an American and believe in disseminating the truth, and that is why, after this newscast, I'm resigning.
Liz Wall joins us now. This is her first TV interview since quitting RT America. Also, Jill Doherty is back with us. She'll also be asking questions. Liz, it's good to have you on the program. Obviously, your announcement stunned a lot of people. Why did you decide to resign during your newscast? Because you've been working there for like 2.5 years. Clearly, you're familiar with the perspective of RT America, the kind of stuff, the kind of stories they put on the air. So why today?
Why today? That's a good question. I think the coverage, as we're in this diplomatic standoff and during the escalation of this crisis in Crimea, I think the propagandist nature of RT came out in full force. Today, for example, I had an interview with Ron Paul. The only question that I asked, I asked many questions. I asked about the Russian intervention. You know, he has a very anti-intervention approach. I asked him in the wake of escalation by the Russian military, how long, how should we respond to this? How should the U.S. respond to this? And that question was cut out of the interview. There was another segment today. It was a news package from one of our correspondents that painted the opposition over there in the Ukraine as having neo-Nazi elements. And I think that's very dangerous when you have a new government instability over there. And I'm sure that there are, in fact, neo-Nazi elements, but to portray the entire opposition as being part of this right-wing extremist group is going along with the narrative that Vladimir Putin wants to go along with.
Was this something you had always felt pressure? I mean, how does it work at RT? How, you know, where do directions come from?
The direction comes from management, and I think there's a lot of young people that work there, some people inexperienced, and I think that they're eager to please management. There's a form of self-censorship that you learn. Eventually, you learn what management likes, what management dislikes. Today, especially with the heightened situation in Crimea, overtly questions are being written. That very, very loaded questions. Questions basically to paint the picture and to present the Putin perspective in all of this. And I just think, I mean, I would hope as a reporter and in life, you should always seek the truth. Spread the truth, disseminate the truth. And what's clear is what's happening right now amid this crisis is that RT is not about the truth. It's about promoting a Putinist agenda. And I can tell you firsthand, it's also about bashing America.